Hi, welcome back. Today we are going to learn the mensuration, the class 8th NCERT mathematics. You people will come across, what is the mensuration? The mensuration is the branch of mathematics which deals with the measurement. What is the measurement? The measurement which the geometrical figures like length, breadth, area, perimeters, volumes, etc. These are the basics. You might have learned your 7th standard portion. What is the rectangle? What is square? What is the triangle? What is the parallelogram? Okay, I need not explain what it is. Just today we are going to learn what is the area and perimeters, and we will solve the first exercise. Okay, this is a rectangle. Rectangle, okay, just let me brief about the geometrical figures. Rectangle. Rectangle is the which is opposite sides are equal, right? Length and breadth. So let me write what is the area of the rectangle. The area of a rectangle is length into breadth. Then what is perimeter? Area is the boundary. The area is the boundary. What is the enclosed figure? The value of enclosed figure is called a area. And the total length, which is covered, it's called a perimeter. The perimeter of a rectangle is 2 times L plus B. That means I can write it is 2 length plus 2 breadth, right? The two breadth. Take 2 common, it is L plus B. That's what it is. So 2 times length into breadth. This is length plus breadth. This is a rectangle. Square, you know what is the square? The meaning of square is all sides are equal. So area of square is A square. Where A is A, B is B. So A square is side into side. That is side into side. Then what is perimeter? I told it is a measurement of all the length. So A, 4 times. So 4 times the side. Next, triangle. What is the triangle? The area of the triangle is half into base into height. This is the base, this is the height. The perimeter of a triangle is, this is L1, L2, L3. Summation of all the sides, L1 plus, L2 plus, L3. This is will give the perimeter of triangle. Let us come to parallelogram. What is the parallelogram? The area of parallelogram is base into height. Base into height. What is the perimeter? Perimeter is 2 times sum of adjacent sides. Then, what is circle? Area of a circle is pi r square. R is the radius of a circle. Now pi is the constant value. You know that pi, the value of pi is 22 by 7. That is 3.142. Constant. Then what is the perimeter? Perimeter is 2 pi r. Perimeter also got a circumference. It's 2 pi r. Then semicircle. Area of a semicircle is half of that. Half of the area. Like pi r square. Half circle, right? Then perimeter is only pi r. Not 2 times, it is only pi r. These are the basics. Let us recap. The rectangle is area length into breadth. Square is side into side. Triangle is half into base into height. Parallelogram is base into height. Circle pi r square. This is half pi r square. These are the basics. Let me move on the exercise. Let us have the question. A square and a rectangular filled with the measurements as given in the figure. So have the same perimeter which fit at the larger area. The question is very simple. Here the two figures given. One is a square, other is a rectangle. The side is given here. What they convey in that? The perimeter of the both the figure is same. So find which is the areas, which is the larger area. It is very simple. Let us start from the basic. The square. What is the area of a square? The area of a square is side into side. That is A square. So what is the, here this is the A. So area of a square side is 60 into 60. That is 3600 meter square. This is the area of a square. Then perimeter. Perimeter is what? 4 times the side. So 4 times the side is again 60. That is 6424, 0. That is 240 meter is your perimeter of square. Let us move on to the second figure. This is a rectangle. Here, what is the area of a rectangle? The area of a rectangle is length into breadth. What is the length? Length is 80 given. We don't know the breadth. See area. Then, what is perimeter? The perimeter of rectangle is 2 times L plus B. Right? 2 times L plus B. So, what is the perimeter here? The perimeter is, as the question is clear, have the same perimeter. Here already you found the square, the perimeter is 240. Here, so the perimeter of rectangle also 240. Then 2, what is the length? Length is 80, we don't know the breadth. Then how to do it now? Okay, let me erase this. It is this. So here you form the area of the square is 3600 meter square and the perimeter is 240 meter. Okay. Now the perimeter is here, this is over, right? So 240 is equal to, that is 2 will come here, 2 will come here, then 80 plus B here. 2 1s are, 2 2s are 0, that is 120 is equal to 80 plus B. I want B here. So right here, this is left side, that is 80 plus B is equal to 180. We can change it, right? This is a basic, A is equal to B or B is equal to A, both are same. Right, whatever the equation you find out, for left side and this right side, then B. B is equal to the basic rule is, if there is a plus or minus is there, you have to retain. When the particular number is going there, we have to change the sign. And if it is equal to, then it will come the divided. So now B is equal to 120 divided by, 120 minus 80. So breadth is equal to 120 minus 80, how much it is? This 40. So 40. 40 meter is the breadth. Now, so the perimeter, see, area is 80 into B, because since B breadth you don't know. So we found out the perimeter is equal to this. We found out breadth is 40 meter. So length is 80 meter and breadth is equal to 40 meter. Then, let us find now what is the area of a rectangle. We know that area of a rectangle is length into breadth. So length is 80, breadth is 40. Now, 8 4s are 32, 0 0, that is meter square. Area of a rectangle is 3200 meter square. Here what we found is, area of a square is 3600 meter square. Since we have the same perimeter, here area of a square is 3600 meter square and area of a rectangle is 3200 meter square. Hence, we can tell that the area of a square is larger than the rectangle. So let us move on the second question. Mrs. Kaushik has a square plot with the measurement as shown in the figure. This is a square plot 25 by 25. And she wants to construct the house in the middle of that. And she wants to develop a garden around that. Find the cost of the garden developing of this. This is a question brief about. And the rate of 55 meter square. Per meter square it is 55 rupees. Then you have to find out what is the total cost of the garden. So let us focus. This is the house. And this is the total of the plot. And this is a garden. The green color what I am writing is, it's a garden. This is a house. Also over here. So that is, the question clearly brief about that. Mrs. Kaushik has a plot, that is square shape in the plot. Plot is in square shape. So first you have to find out the area of this. Then, house. See the dimensions. Or length and the breadth. It is not equal. Then it is a rectangle. Okay. Then, first you have to find out the area of the plot. Then area of the house. Then you have to find out what is the area of the required for the garden. Okay, let us move on the question one by one. So, area of the plot is equal to we know that side into side. If since it is a square part, it is side into side, that is 25 into 25. That is equal to 625 meter square. It is the area of the plot. Then the house here they are not mentioned. It is which type of house, which what shape of it is. The once you focus on that, we come to know square means all sides are equal. Here 20 meter and 15, obviously it is a rectangle. So area of the house, area of house is equal to length into breadth. What is the length? Length is 20, the breadth is 15. So that is 300 meter square. Now we have to find the total cost developed in the garden. So before that, we have to find what is the area of the garden. Now area of the garden is equal to, so I want this area. So area of the plot minus area of the house, it will give the area of the garden. That is area of plot minus area of house. So area of the plot is what? 625 meter square. The area of the house is 300, which gives you 325 meter square. 625 minus 300 is 325 meter square. Now what we found is area of the garden. Here the question is, find the total cost which is developing a garden. Now we found out the area of the garden. Then, so here clearly given this, the per meter square, to develop a garden per meter square charges about 55 rupees. Then what is the cost of total area, a total developing garden? Now the total cost of the garden, to develop a garden is area. I should write area 325 into 55 rupees per meter square. Multiply these two. So that is 325 into 55. Multiply these two, 25 into carry, 10, 12, 1 carry, 5, 3, 0, 15, 1, 16. And then same thing, 1, 6, 2, 5. Then 5, 7, 8, 7. Okay, that is 17,000. That is rupees 17,875 is your total cost required to develop a garden. So now let us move question number 3. Let us move on to question number 3. The shape of the garden is a rectangle in the middle and semicircle at the ends. Show the diagram. This is the diagram which is given. The garden, the shape of the garden is given. It is a rectangle as well as two semicircles at the end. Okay. Now we have to find out what is the area of the garden and the perimeter of the garden. So before that, let us find the how many figure is there. See here, this is one. This is a rectangle. This is semicircle. This is also semicircle. So now, area of the garden is equal to area of rectangle plus 2 times area of semicircle. Why it is 2 times? It is 2 semicircle. Okay. Now, what is the area of a rectangle? Here, area of the total length is given 20. First you find out what is the length of this. The length. How to find out? 20. Here the radius, the diameter is given 7 meter. The radius is half of that, is 3.5. Here also it is 3.5. The length is 20 minus 3.5, that is 7. 20 minus 7 is 13. So I can write the area of a rectangle is length into breadth. Then 2 times, what is the area of a semicircle? Area of a circle is pi r square. As I told, area of a semicircle is half of pi r square. So let us write now, what is the length? The length is 13 meter into breadth. Breadth is, so that is 7. This is 7. So breadth is 7. 13 into 7 plus 2 times into half of pi r square. So pi, value of pi is 22/7, then r square. What is the radius? So radius I told 3.5, you can write that is 7/2, the whole square. Simplification to be easy. Now 7 3 7 21. 91 plus 22 get cancelled, then here 22/7, then 49/4. 7 7 is 49, 2 2 is 4, then 2 2 is 4, 2 11 is 7 7 is 7. Now that is 91 plus 7 7 is 77 divided by 2. So let us find the LCM. The LCM is equal to 2 divided by 1 2s are 2, here we have to multiply by 2. So that will become 2 1s are 2, 2 9s are 18, 182. That is 182 plus here 77. So add these two, 7 plus 2 is 9. Then again 7 plus 8 is 15. So 259/2. Now the area of the garden, total area of the garden is 259 divided by 2. You will get as 129.5 meter square. This is what you found out area of the garden. Now, so area of the rectangle plus area of the semicircle. It is very simple. Here the rectangle length into breadth. As you are given the total length is 20 meter. You have to do is here the radius is 3.5. 20 minus 3.5 plus 3, that is 7. So 13. You got the 13. The length, breadth, you know, 7. You multiply, then area of the semicircle is, circle is pi r square, area of semicircle is half of pi r square. Substitute here, you will get 129.5 meter square. So now, let us find here, area is over. Let us find the perimeter of the garden. The perimeter of the garden is, perimeter of rectangle plus 2 times perimeter of semicircle. Just recall the formula. Perimeter of rectangle is nothing but 2 times L plus B plus 2 times the semicircle. That is, what is the perimeter of a circle is pi, 2 pi r. So perimeter of a semicircle is only pi r. Since it is 2 semicircles total, it is 1 circle. This is 2 pi r. Substitute the value 2. Length, as I told, 20 minus 3.5 is 3.7. That is, length is 13. Breadth is 7 plus 2. Pi is 22/7. Radius is 7/2. So 7 7 cancel. 2 2 cancel. Now it is 13 plus 7 is 20. 20 into 2. So 20 into 2 is 40 plus here 22. Your answer is 40 plus 20 is 62 meters is your perimeter of a garden. So area, what I told, area of the circle, area of the garden, what we got is 129.5 meter square. This is how the problem ends. So let me move on the next problem. Let us move on the question number 4. A fluorine tile has the shape of a parallelogram. It is very clear. The tile is the shape of the parallelogram. Now whose base is 24 cm and the height is 10 cm. How many such tiles is required to floor? Area is given. So area of the parallelogram is given. So area of the flooring is given. For example, this is the flooring. How many tiles is required? So this is what you have to find out. How many tiles is required? So the question is very clear. To find how many such tiles are required, for that what is the formula? Number of tiles. Number of tiles is equal to, you have to find out. So what is the area of the floor first? Area of the floor. Area of the floor divided by, so we have area of the floor divided by area of the flooring of tile. Area of flooring of single tile. So total area of the floor and here the flooring outer. Here the floor is 1080. So you need to find out what is the area of the first flooring of the tile. Let us first find area of the flooring tile. Then we can divide. We will get number of tiles. So let us find area of a flooring tile. Flooring tile. The tile. So the tile is in the shape of what? It is very clearly given parallelogram. Let us draw the parallelogram. The length is given here. The length is 24 centimeter. Here is 24. The height. The height is 10 centimeter. Now, area of the flooring tile. There are that nothing but parallelogram. The parallelogram is B into H. The base is 24. H is 10. It is 240 meter square. 240 centimeter square. Very clear. Here the finding, here the given length is centimeter. You have to find out centimeter square. Okay. Then, so cover the floor area. Okay. Now, area of the floor tile is over. Now you have to find out the number of tiles. To proceed the number of tiles, first you convert. Both units should be same. Either you have to convert the area of flooring centimeter square into meter square, or this meter square you convert into centimeter square. So, okay, it is easy to convert this meter square into centimeter square. You know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Now, just let us write now floor area. Floor area is equal to 1080 meter square. Now, 1080 meter square converted into centimeter. The meter is 100 centimeter. 100 into 100. That is 100 meter square. 100 into 100. That corresponds to. So this is your area of the floor area. Now we can substitute. So number of tiles is area of the floor. Area of the floor is, don't write 1080. You write it in 1080 100 into 100 divided by. So what is the area of the tile? You got 240. Substitute. Cut 1010, then 24. If you multiply this together, if you do it, you will get the answer is 4500 tiles is required. Just check out. 45,000 tiles is required. So 24, if you simplify, 2 1s are, 2 2s are, 2 5s are, 2 4s are, again 2 5s are 10, 50, again 2 6s are 12, 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14, then 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10, so 3 1s are 3, 3 9s are 27, 90. Now 90 into 25 into 10. 90 into 25 into 10. So 500, 59 are 45. So 200, 29 are 18. So now, so that it will give you 45,000. So it will give 45,000. Number of tiles is 45,000 numbers. So just recall the question. A flooring tile is here clearly given. It is the shape of parallelogram. Tile is the parallelogram, not a floor. So now the area of the floor already given. You need not to bother. What is the area shape of the floor? They given directly here. Just find out the area of the floor. That is B into H parallelogram. You get in the centimeter, because unit is centimeter, centimeter square. Now look into that. The area is given here meter square. Don't directly substitute 1080 divided by no. This is given in meter square. You have to convert in centimeter square. That is 1 centimeter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Here 1080 into 100 by 100. So that you write here divided by 240, you will get 45,000 numbers in the tiles. Okay. Let us move on the next question. Let us move on the last question in the exercise. That is, the ant is moving around the few food pieces which is scattered here. So find out the which food piece would the ant have to take larger round. So you know that ant, it has to go like this and like this. Each figure, please you have to imagine and you have to write
perimeter. Okay, let us take the first one. Let us find a hole. This is what the ant moves here. Start. Let us start here. Ant will move here. Ant move here. This is what this is. So perimeter. Perimeter of food A. So food A is this shape. Let us find what this. This is perimeter of semicircle. Semicircle plus, see, ant has to move here, semicircle plus here, 2 times the radius. It has to come here to here. Our diameter can take. Now, so perimeter of semicircle is what? Pi into r. Pi into r is semicircle. Then this is 2r. Let us find 22/7. What the radius here? So that is 2.8 divided by 2 plus 2r. 2 into again 2.8 divided by 2. Please concentrate. Pi r is the perimeter of semicircle. Then here ant started here. Again it has to come back. From here to here the radius, here to here is the full is the diameter. So 2 times r. If you take this is the r, it's the 2 times r. Pi r plus 2r. Substitute the value here. Then obtain 22/7. If you this you get 22/7. Here 1.4 centimeter. Again it is 2 into 1.4. If you substitute here, add, you will get this is 4.4 centimeter. Again, 42 to 28 is 2.8 centimeter. Put together 4 plus 2, 8 plus 2, 12. That is 2. That is 7.2. 7.2 centimeter is your where the ant will take the full round. So it's very simple. Perimeter of food A is it is looks like it is semicircle and started here. It is go pi r. Then here after it has come back. From here, started point here. So this is what diameter. So 2 times radius. Pi r, 2r. 22/7 into what is the radius is 2.8/2 plus this substitute. You will get this answer 7.2 centimeter. So let us go foot B. The foot B is foot B again. It is very simple. What is the foot B? So let us find perimeter of foot B. So let us concentrate. Let's and start here. It is in a rectangle. So this is what? Here this dimension is given 1.5 centimeter. This is 1.5 centimeter. So let us and start here. 1.5 centimeter here. Again, let's go the length of 2.8. Again, let's come back 1.5. Again, it has to take a round. That is area of a semicircle. Now, that is 1.5 centimeter. Plus 2.8 centimeter, take a round, again come back, 1.5 centimeter, plus this is pi r, semicircle, so let us write directly, so pi r is nothing but, so 3 centimeter, plus 2.8, that is pi r, 22/7, r is again, 2.8/2, 3 plus 2 that 5.8 centimeter plus 11. So if you substitute, you will get 4.4 centimeter. 5.8 plus 4.4 centimeter will get 10.2 centimeter. It's very simple. The ant has to move here, length of the rectangle 1.5 centimeter. Again the rectangle, length of the rectangle, again the breadth of the rectangle, plus here a semicircle pi r, you get 10.2 centimeter. So remember, what the area you got here, so your first one area you got, that is 7.2 centimeter, not perimeter, sorry, perimeter you got 7.2 centimeter, here the perimeter of a foot B, you got, perimeter is equal to 10.2 centimeter. So let us find the last one. That is foot C. By looking, it looks like difficult, but it's very easy. Just to concentrate, stick on to the basics. the perimeter of food C. The food C is what? Yeah, let us angle start here. This is 2 cm plus, again, this is here at a semicircle, pi r. So, pi r. So, this is length plus pi r, again length. That is pi is 22 by 7, radius is 2.8 by 2, plus again length is 2 cm. Now, just to simplify this, 2 plus again 122 by 7 into 1.4 plus 2, nothing but 2 plus 2 is 4, this will be 4.4. Yeah, then total is 8.4 cm. Now, the perimeter of food is 8.4 cm. So, just see that which one has greater perimeter. Simple. Food 1 is got 7.2 cm, food B is got 10.2 and food C is got 8.4. It is clearly you can tell that food B, for food B, the ant has to take and has to move a larger room. Ant has to take larger round. Is 10.2 cm. Dear student, I hope that you people understood this exercise. Please stick on to the basics. Whatever I explained in the starting, that you go through the formulas, then read the question twice, stick on to the basics, then you can you may find it very easy. So next I'll catch up you people in the next exercise.